Hi there, welcome along to another video. We're going to do an unboxing and reviewing video. We've got a few goodies that I've been buying of late. Couldn't resist it. So one of these is new, one of these is second hand. So we're going to start with the Locomotive. And this is one I've picked up at a very reasonable price. It's the Hornby Class 50, but in weathered. And this is the factory applied weathering. Network Southeast livery for 50045 Achilles, and this is Hornby catalogue number R2350, and this was out a few years ago, and it's the super detailed Hornby Class 50. I think there was a sort of more basic one before that. Certainly Lima produced a model of the Class 50, which was bit basic, probably nice for its time, but we're going to open this up now, and actually we're going to slide that out of the slip case. And this is a feature actually of a lot of the new Hornby locomotives, is you have this sort of plain cardboard slip case with a nice photographic picture of the model on the front. And in many ways actually, I mean, because this is actually a photograph of the model itself rather than the real thing, it actually works out quite nice, because if you look there, it's hidden away in the box behind all this plastic and stuff. And so actually that gives you a much better idea of what the locomotive you're buying looks like. So we just put that to one side. We've opened the end here. We've got inside the little flap. We've got all the detail of what it is that's in the box, which you can see through this sort of cellophane window. But we're going to slide all of this out. Now, one thing I will say about the Hornby locomotives is be very careful when you unwrap these things, because the design of the box, to avoid any damage sliding the thing in and out, means that if you're not careful and you're not ready for it, it's very easy to end up just dropping the model on the floor. And that's because we've got this cellophane in front of the model. Take that off and put it to one side. But what we actually do with this, instead of, as with the Backman models, just lifting it out, no, we don't do that with this. Place it so the model is upright but within the polystyrene, and then the top of the polystyrene just lifts off there, and that exposes the locomotive without this sort of rubbing on the detail. And there is a lot of quite intricate detail on this, and then we can just lift that out from the bottom part of the packaging, and there we have it. It's actually pretty good packaging in that respect, because you can get this out without causing any damage. And we've got the cardboard bottom with the catalogue details on the end there, and of course the obligatory patronising instructions on not to plug it directly to the mains and stuff like that. Is anybody stupid enough to do that? Actually, yeah, it probably is somebody stupid enough to do that. So anyway, here we have the model. We've got it in the Network Southeast toothpaste livery. And I actually quite like this livery. It's from the sort of the sectorisation period. So sort of mid to late 1980s into 1990s, I suppose. There is a little bit of damage there, but this was a second-hand item. I paid £55 for this, so I'm not overly bothered about that. And to be honest, I've only just noticed it, so it's not like it's a major, major issue. Now, we've got the factory-applied weathered livery on this. It's very crisply applied, so we've got no bleed on the stripes as they go down there. There's no, like, fuzziness at the edge. And the grills on this model side, if I tilt the model up, I can actually see through some of these grills. They actually are proper louvres, which is quite nice. And just like on the Hornby's up-to-date Class 8, Class 9 model, the cab doors actually open. They're on a spring, so you can push them in. And to be honest, in some respects, I think that that's a case of detail because we can, not because it's necessary. Because how do you actually wedge them open? I suppose you could cut a very thin sliver of plastic off something like a plastic sprue on a kit and wedge it in there. But really, it's just gimmicks for the sake of gimmicks. Another example of that is that there's a nice roof fan in there, but it actually spins round. It's connected to the motor, so when this locomotive runs, that roof fan spins. But really, in all honesty, I'd rather they hadn't bothered and just kept the cost down, because it probably seems like a really good idea, a bragging point on paper, but actually, it's detail that isn't necessary. Now, we've got on this the buffer beam detail applied, and you can see there is a lot of buffer beam detail going on there. Now, this has had the coupling removed from one end. It remains on the other end, and there's lesser detail applied on there. So it can still pull the train, but we've got our front end there with all the detail applied, and it is quite nice. It does enhance the locomotive, but by the same token, it means that realistically we can only really run this in one direction. We've got our separately applied etched nameplates on there, so we get a nice raised finish. That's Achilles. These were named after Second World War warships. So this one, particularly one, is named after HMS Achilles, which I think, and don't get me wrong, was either a battleship or a battle cruiser. I've a feeling it was involved with the Battle of the River Plate, but again, I could be very much wrong on that. But this followed in with the tradition that had started with the Class 42 and Class 43 warship class locomotives on the Western region that were named after battleships. And these locomotives, originally the real ones, they were built by at Newton Le Willows at the Vulcan Foundry, and were actually leased to British Railways. And they appeared in the late 60s, so they had a three-digit D-prefixed number, and then later renumbered as a Class 50. And at some point in the early 1970s, British Rail actually outright bought them. They bought out the lease. And then as some of the high diesel hydraulic classes like the Westerns and the warships got rid of on the Western region, and the electrification process of the East Coast Main Line was completed, these locomotives were transferred to the Western region and then rebuilt in the sort of mid to late 1980s, which is when they started to work some of the network southeast routes, and hence they got this rather distinctive toothpaste style livery applied to them. And I'm trying to think actually of other locomotives that I know of. I think the only ones I can think of would be the Class 47 and the Class 8 are the only two others I can immediately think of that got this rather eye-catching toothpaste livery. And obviously there were EMU and DMU units that did as well, but in terms of locomotives, excuse me. But the detail is very well applied. We've even got down to, with the weathered finish, you can see on the windows the sweep that the windscreen wipers would make on the real thing. So it's got like a clean patch on the window glass, which is a nice touch with the weathering, which you wouldn't necessarily get without care and attention being applied in the weathering stage. It's a very light factory application of weathering, and that's pretty good, because to be honest, these being passenger locomotives wouldn't have been allowed to get absolutely filthy. But there we have it, the Hornby Class 50 locomotive, the super detailed Class 50 locomotive. It's a lovely locomotive, and it is one I have to say that probably for the past 10 years at least, I've been meaning to get this particular Hornby model, but it's always been the case that when I've been in the shop looking to buy one, there's been something else that I wanted slightly more at the time. And when I saw this second-hand in decent condition, the opportunity was just there, and I thought, yeah, come on, Jenny, you can treat yourself. So I now finally have Class 50 in my fleet. Anyway, I hope that's been informative for you. Don't forget to like this video and share it too, and look back through the channel and you can see all those other lovely videos that we've been doing. Anyway, you take very good care of yourself, and this is me, Jenny Kirk, saying bye for now.